Hey you, yeah you. Tell me, what comes to mind when you think of tower defense games? Do you think of Bloons Tower Defense? Or perhaps COD Zombies? Or maybe even the Vox? Well, maybe you don't, and you think of Roblox games. There are tons of Roblox tower defense games such as Tower Heroes, Tower Defense Simulator, Ether Rush, Metro Cubes. All the games I just listed are amazing and different takes on the tower defense genre. So with that being said, what game will I be talking about? Well, if you read the title, it's Tower Battles. So let's start with a quick question. What's the base game like? Well, the base game is really simple. Jump in a game, play for a while, win or lose, get money, buy units, repeat. It's a simple format for a complex game. There are so many mechanics you have to learn, like money game, placement limit, sending, round structure, unit damage, unit range, cliff towers, hidden enemies, and many, many more. So let's jump into the first part of the video, versus mode. Versus mode has 4 different options: 1v1, 2v2, 3v3, 4v4. Now, while I play versus mode a lot in tower battles, but I only really play 1v1 and 2v2, but most of the time 2v2 because I play with my friend Pootis. Hoss editing the video actually, she's pretty epic. She also made the GFX as you see on screen. Anyways, let's dive into details on versus. So what are the basics? Well, you spawn in and are randomly put into a team. Unless you are in a party, then you will be in a team with your party mates. The game starts and both teams have 100 health just like normal. The goal is to outlast the other team all means necessary. There is a mechanic that lets you send zombies to the other team, a good way to get a win. However, it's not always the best choice. So how do you outlast the other team? Well, many people come up with strategies that can be really good. However, the main point of versus is to come up with strategies on your own. Coming up with a successful strategy can be hard, but with enough fine-tuning it can be really strong. So here's a quick tutorial by Josh Maps, the man himself, on making strategies. Truly a beautiful piece of art. Oh yeah. Anyways, let's talk on the topic of sending for a second. Sending is really good in most strategies because it can make your opponent think of weaknesses, strengths, and how much money you will be able to spend on spam. However, some people are on a never-ending crusade to demonize sending. GG, I won. No, you only won, because you sent, you big fat noob. Go rot in the very depths of the underworld. You deserve death. Go kill yourself. You ruined the game, you rapist. I hope you get hit by a bus. I will get your account banned, fatty. You should learn how to play the game. You are a rass and gonna go brag to my 3 Twitter followers that I won an argument in game. Hang yourself, kid. Yeah, sending will make loads of people snap. They always say stuff like, you ruin the experience of the game, or sending is for noobs. Stop being so bad and get good. There's also people who send way too early, and they don't get any money on bar defense. Dealing with these guys is fun, because they act like they only lost because they had a bad team member or the game glitched, and they didn't get money properly, or you were hacking because you survived for way too long. I could go on and on about the excuses these guys make, but that would take like 7 minutes. Well, with that being said, let's move on to part 2. Okay, so survival is a pretty fun game mode. I like playing it with friends. Oh, and there is a way to win, unlike versus mode, that just keeps going till one team dies. Survival mode has an end that gives you 150 credits. Survival is a really good place To start, as it's easier to get credits, I recommend grinding credits in survival mode, getting a loadout of farm, enforcer, patrol, and commando. This is a really good newbie loadout. You should get this before going into versus. And that's all I could think of to describe survival mode. It's cool, I guess, but it's just versus mode. But solo it is a lot harder, and it's really satisfying to win. With that, let's move on to the final verdict. Well, I think this game is great. It inspired a lot of fan games to be made, and even got me into the tower defense scene on Roblox. So with that being said, what do I score it? Well, I give it a 8.8 out of 10. I really hope this game gets updated more often. It took almost a year to get an update. Sure, the update was the largest yet, but still, that was a lot of time. So with that being said, my name is C. Maku, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.